Hi guys, and welcome back to VR Essentials, where we talk about the practical uses of virtual reality. Today we're talking about the Quest 3 How to Beginner's Guide, and we're going to look at all the privacy stuff, which is really, really important, of course, because especially if you're a parent, you want to be able to, you know, not allow or allow or enable or disable certain apps to be accessed by your young ones. And also for us as a consumer, we want to know what we want Meta to be able to track, not to track, allow what other people see, whether you want to be a bit hidden, a bit invisible, you know, and just make sure that we're safe and comfortable when we are using the Meta Quest 3, of course. Now do go and check out the, you know, of course, the actual playlist of the beginner's guide, how to, as we spoke about how to record video, change the bitrate, change the frame rates, change the format, transfer files from the actual Quest 3 to your actual PC as well. And then another video we looked at the differences, between 90 Hz and 120 Hz and how you can change that and what it might affect, not just in your headset, but for example, when you're casting, whether you choose one or the other and all these kind of different things. So do smash the likes, guys, so more people get to discover the playlist and all these videos, and we can also grow the YouTube VR Essentials community together, of course, and hit the notification bell after you subscribe, guys, to be notified of all the juicy videos coming very, very soon. All right, let's hop into VR. All right, so we're back inside of the VR headset. So what we're going to do is go to settings and then go directly to privacy, which is located here. And you'll see on the left-hand side panel here, there's quite a little bit of things that are accessible here. So let's go one by one and slowly, and do make sure to have a cup of coffee with you or something as you're watching today's video. So the first thing is audience and visibility. Meta have made sure that you are able to change who can see your activity. This controls who can see your activity, like the apps you use, achievements, high scores associated with those apps. So you can choose only me, or you can also let your followers know. For yourself, show your active status. So active status allows your followers and connections to see when you're active, recently active, or currently in the same chat as them. You'll also see when people you follow and connections are active or recently active. Active status is visible to followers and connections when they have it turned on, okay? So basically for me, I just leave it, not active, so that people don't really get to see when I'm active or when I'm not, so a little bit invisible basically. Now here for hide app activity, you can show or hide your ownership activity and active status for specific apps. So whenever if you want your friends to know all these kind of little details, you can on or you can off it, and so that they don't know what apps you have, or whether they know the apps that you have, you can basically change it here also. So that's for the beginners. Then we can go to social connections. Social connections is private profile. So you can make your profile private. When turned on, you'll receive requests to approve followers. Only your followers can see your following and followers list. Your profile info, like name, username, bio, profile picture, and avatar, will remain public. People can still search for your name or username and send you follow requests. So if you want it to be completely private, you can basically, switch it off, turn off private profile. Sorry, you can disable it so that it's no longer private, so that when you turned off, anyone can follow you without your approval. Your pending followers request will be approved. Anyone can see your following or followers list. So, of course, I'm going to leave it to cancel. You can also bind, by the way, your Meta headset to various different profiles. So, this is some Instagram and also some Facebook things there also. And then you can see who you're basically, following people on Horizon. At the moment, I'm not in Horizon. And do hit the notification bell after you subscribe, everybody, as I will provide more details about Horizon, of course, as it's available in my region. All right, next, let's go to device permissions, hand and body tracking. Hand and body tracking, it's amazing that this VR headset can actually track the body. Allows you to switch between hands and controllers, have a more seamless or immersive experience, and make your avatar's movements look more realistic. When enabled, your headset collects data about your hand and body poses and estimates hand size and body scale, as explained in the hand and body
privacy notice. So you can basically enable or disable this. Location services uses sources like crowdsourced Wi-Fi hotspots to determine your device location. Turning location services on lets you give apps permission to access your device's location data. So again, you could switch this off so that it doesn't know your location service, or you could leave it on for me. I'm actually going to leave it on because, of course, I wanted to find my Wi-Fi hotspot. Point cloud, share and point cloud data. Share point cloud data with Meta to expand your headset's capabilities and enable features like local multiplayer. So I'm going to switch this off as I don't really need this, to be honest with you. Permissions. Okay, so this is going to be very good for, especially for parents and things. So you can allow the calendar to be patched to Messenger. You can allow the call logs to be patched to WhatsApp if you want as well. You can enable the camera to be patched to various different things. So I leave it off for now. Contacts also, of course, if you want all these various different apps to sync to your contacts, then you can enable or disable. But by right, it should be disabled already. Location is all on off also. So location service uses sources like crowdsource Wi-Fi hotspots. So we just spoke about this. So basically, it's all off at the moment, which is great. And then for microphone, it's also, you can switch it on, switch it off depending on the app. So for now, for WhatsApp, I will switch it off. Messenger, I will switch it off. And MetaQuest browser, I'll leave it on for now and we'll do a test. So do hit the notification bell after you subscribe. After I test for this for Cybrix, we'll put it on. Also, great app. Do hit the notification bell after you subscribe for the review of Cybrix coming soon. Also, nearby devices. So this will basically get to find your nearby devices. So Messenger, I don't have it, so I just switch it off. MetaQuest Move, I'll leave it on for now, although I don't have the app installed at this moment in time. Phone. Okay, so which phones? Again, you can switch it on or switch it off for the WhatsApp and Messenger. And then if we go back to SMS, same thing, you can send some SMS via Messenger or WhatsApp. So for me, it's switched off at the moment. Spatial data. So also same thing for spatial data. You can choose based on different environments. Now, I do know that Cybrix does have spatial data. So I will turn on spatial data to use apps that blend virtual reality, real world environment. I'm not sure if First Encounters has it or not, but I'll just switch it on just in case for that. And then storage, of course. So, you know, this will tell you what application you wanted to access your storage and which application you do not want it to access your storage. And then you also have app locks, everybody. So you are able to actually lock specific apps using a specific pattern. So this is pretty cool, especially for parents if they don't want their kids to use specific apps. So do make sure you do go to this. If you are a parent and your child is very young, I will put a list of all the games that you should more or less have to do this. But any shooter game, I highly recommend that you don't have your kids being able to access. Of course, any game that is freemium where you can basically buy stuff on the go using your credit card and there's no authentication, it's all automatic and you press pay. I also suggest that you put, of course, the app lock on also. And then you can also see via your app installed. So Cubism at the moment is installed, which I really, really love, by the way. Do go and check out the actual video about Cubism itself that I used before. Let me just go back to privacy, see if we missed anything. So data analytics, same thing. You can share additional data to improve MetaQuest. So I switch it off. And you can also switch on voice commands storage. After I believe you switch this on, then this will come up here. Although voice command storage doesn't seem to have anything at the moment. Safety and legal. So terms of service, you can go and read it. Meta privacy policy, you can go and read it. Supplemental terms of services, you can go and read it. Supplemental privacy policy, you can go and read it from here. Code of conduct for VR virtual experiences, you can also go and read it from here.
So guys, this video, by the way, is sponsored by VR-Wave.store. I have been working with them for at least 4 years on the HP Reverb G2 and the Oculus Quest 1. Never had a problem. Oh my God, they've dropped so many times. No scratches, nothing. I'm really happy with them. And I'm happy to announce that I will be receiving MetaQuest 3 prescription lenses as well. as well as the Pimax Crystal and also Pico 4, as I just ordered my Pico 4 recently, as I just got my eyes checked finally. And you do get a promo code 5% off using the VR Essentials promo code. So 5% discount, everybody, using the promo code VR Essentials. Do go and check them out. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you got a lot out of this and that now you're set and you can actually set up your privacy to be comfortable and feel safe within your Meta Quest 3. Smash the likes, everybody, so more people get to discover this video and we can grow the YouTube VR Essentials community together. And hit the notification bell after you subscribe, of course, so you're notified of all the juicy videos coming very, very soon, including Oculus Link, Air Link, Virtual Desktop, and testing out all the various different apps, of course, without a doubt. All right, see you in this video or in that video. Until next time, take it easy. Bye, 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 bye.